G'day, welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use AutoFill in a spreadsheet with formulas. But I'm going to add a situation where, let's say we want to times all our answers here by the price or a single price. Okay, obviously you don't want to be writing that price on every line. So we're just going to write the price once and then set up the formula and the autofills so that it will actually times each of these by this cell as we drag it down, okay? So the first step in our first column, sorry, I'm just gonna copy this down, it's annoying me. So they're all equals. So I wanna get the total price in this column. So obviously the total price will be this total here times by our price, okay? So the formula is pretty easy, it's gonna be equals that number there, times our price, enter, $10. That works great there. Now, the problem is, if you have a look at the formula over here, that's referencing G3, which is this cell here, and L3, which is the cell the price is in. If I drag this down and use my autofill, I get zero because this formula here is referencing G4, which is the 12, but then it's referencing L4, which is the blank cell underneath the price. So that's not working. So the way we do it is we can actually lock this autofill onto this cell. And you can lock it by rows or lock it by columns. And the way you do it is you put a dollar sign in front of the position or the reference for that cell. So this cell is L3. Okay, 3L, L3. So if I go back over here and find my L3, I can lock it by row and by column. So lock the row, you put a dollar sign in front of the L. That means it will always read out of that column. Okay, and to lock the row, you put a dollar sign in front of the 3. Okay. So nothing's changed here yet. But now when I use autofill and drag this down to the next line, that will give me 12. 12 by 10 or 12 by 1 is obviously $12. That's because, if you look back here, it's still referencing L3. It hasn't moved, okay? So that row there is G4 by L3. If I move it down one, we're gonna have G5 by L3. So I've now locked the formula onto our price cell, and when we autofill, we will always be timesing by that price. So in a couple of weeks, the price goes up to $1.50, we change the price once, and the price list will change all the way through. We don't have to go adding the price to every item. Okay, so that's how we can lock our autofill, or lock our formula onto one cell.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.